Hey, how's it going, guys? So, Caleb here again. Thank you for checking in. So, this is going to be the first episode of the series to review other people's work. And I think in every single episode, I'm going to pick one work to review. And as mentioned, I want to keep my feedback to be as constructive and informative as possible. So, I already put the design on InVision and I left a lot of comments on InVision. And at the end of the video, I'm going to send that InVision link to the person that sent over the file. So, again, just to mention, these are just my feedback. You know, like when you send me your work, I think you check out my portfolio already. I think you kind of like this thing that I do. So whatever I'm gonna say is just based on my kind of design method, design thinking. Like if I were you in this situation, what kind of thing would I do? And I always keep in mind that like whenever I leave my comments, I always keep in mind that like how can it be informative? How can it be helpful to you to understand like the design kind of like the fundamentals or whatever. In the design. So how can I help you to understand better? So the whole purpose of the video is basically just to help you to improve your design skill and based on my kind of design knowledge. So without further ado, let's just jump right in. So here's the design that I have from Asma on YouTube. And I already have all my feedback on the InVision file. So at the end of the video, I'm going to send you back this InVision link so you can take a look at all my feedback again. So in general, I think the design is not bad, but there's a lot of alignment issue. So what we're going to do is I'm going to go through all the points on InVision to tell you like what I would suggest you change. So the very first one is if you took a look at this hero section in here, you can notice that like this. This padding in here is more than the padding in here. So this alignment issue is very important if you're designing a pixel perfect design. I mean, pixel perfect is what you're kind of like looking to do, then this is the thing that you definitely want to pay attention to. Like the padding in here is not equal. And the second thing is like, if you look at the button, the shadow in here, I think is too harsh. And when you're leaving a shadow on your object, right, you definitely need to think about like, why would you want to leave that shadow? It has to be for a reason, right? You can't just leave a shadow for no reason. So in this case, usually when you do a shadow, maybe like white on white, so you make the content pop above the page, right? So you want to emphasize some of the content. And in this case, I think is like the background color is already pretty dark. So your white button already pops pretty well. So basically you don't need to have a shadow in here. So personally, I would just remove the shadow. And the third thing is pay attention at the padding as well. Like this in here is less than the padding on the left hand side. And again, I think is like the padding in here is much more than this button. So the you know, like the alignment thing, you definitely want to pay attention to that, and the padding as well. It's not equally spaced out. So in here as well, I think the padding is a bit too much. I would narrow it to make this whole thing look like a section, look like a mini section in here. So I'll just make this padding to be a bit smaller. And for the sixth point, what I think is like right now, your subtitle of the logo is really, really small. So I think a lot of people, they're not going to read it anyways. What I would do is I would just center the logo in the header section. So like they have the equal spacing on the top and bottom. So right now you see the bottom one is more than the top one, right? And it doesn't look very aligned. So going down below, what I would do with this section is I think the section is pretty, pretty tight. And I think like our surface, you definitely want to grab more attention. So what I would do is I will increase the padding in here. So just to make this section to be a bit taller. And for this icon as well, I think some of the icon is not realigning. You can see that like this icon is not aligned to the bank. Maybe like just by a few points, but because like personally, I'm super picky about pixel. I want to make all my pixel to be really perfect. So this kind of like misalignment, I can really tell. And the other thing is like, I would like to make the icon to be a bit smaller because like right now, a lot of icon, I think they're a little bit big. If you want to go big, that's okay. Just increase the section so then like they have the east sort of like a better proportion between the icon and the icon title. And also another option you can explore is that like you can make the whole section to be bigger, and then you can make this icon to be on top of the title and give a circle around the icon, so then like you have a home to the icon and everything just spaced out a little bit better, so we can make this section a little bit more catching because I think our surface is pretty important. So down below in here, what I noticed is like the padding, the line height in here is really, really tight. And sometimes when you have like very tight line height, it's very difficult for the read. So what I would do is increase the line height in this section and also pay attention to the padding as well. Like this paragraph and this paragraph, they are very, very tight together. So I'll give more padding in here too. And also like the one of the thing is like the typography, the use of colors and font size and all that. Like I think in general it's not really consistent throughout the page. So you have a font size in here that looks like this big, right? But then down below here, this is like pretty small. So this, like, I cannot find another sort of style of this paragraph throughout the entire site. So these are the things that you want to keep consistent of, right? Like if you have body font to be set as 16 point and then H4 to be set at like let's say 24, then you make the whole thing consistent, right? So this here right now, I think it's a bit inconsistent. And also the color too, right? Like you can see the line height in this paragraph, it's much more than anywhere on the website. And also like the colors in this is a bit lighter than the other paragraphs as well. So these are the things that you want to pay attention to. So going down the section right now, you can see value partners and effects, I don't know this word, but what I would do in here is I would make this title to be a bit smaller, because what I feel right now is that like the title, they're competing attention with the logo. I think in this case, right, I think the logo is what you want to grab people's attention, not the title itself. So what I would do is just make the title a little bit smaller, so then like the just let the logo to be stand a little bit better. And also in here as well, you can notice the border radius in here, they're not consistent. Like this border radius is kind of messed up. I think why you would get to this point, because you drag this box so many times and that mess up your border radius. So these are the things that you definitely want to pay attention to. You make the design look a little bit sloppy when you have like border radius like this. And also this as well, you can notice like the pad is not center, right? This is more to the left and to the right. And logos as well, why is this some of these logo bigger than this logos, right? Is it more important, or you just want to align things? So I think this whole section, definitely pay more attention, play around with it, make things more aligned to the grid. I don't know if you're using grid, but we'll find out. So this section is one of the sections that I like a little bit better, maybe because you pick a stock images. Well, but in general, I think like the spacing in here is a little bit better. But again, like this, see, like this padding in here is more than the padding in here, but in general this feels more space, this more feel more room to breathe. So I like this section a little bit better. So down below here, I noticed that a lot of your title, you have sort of underlined below your title. I don't know the reason for that, but what I would do is at least I will make this sort of line consistent. You see like this line is shorter than this line, right? I'll make this whole thing consistent. And this is a little tweak that I usually like to use. It's when I'm designing a person and then the title, I usually will make the title a little bit smaller to create some kind of hierarchy between the title and the name itself. And this as well, I think the treatment of the navigation is a bit awkward. What I would do is I'll move this button to the left side. So then you can either drag the testimonial or you can tap the button. But then like this is just a bit awkward to me. So down below, again, reduce the spacing, reduce the padding in here. Email, you see like email, this is like shorter than this one. It's just about a few pixels, but I can kind of catch this kind of little things as well. Again, shadow, I don't think you need to have a shadow in here because on Google Map, as I mentioned, you have to give it a reason, right? Some of the Google Map, they're pretty dark already. If you scroll to an area where you have the ocean, even in this case, right, I think you technically you don't need the shadow, and the shadow is a bit harsh in here. So personally, I'll just take away the shadow. And at the last section, again, padding issue, see like this is really, really tight, so we'll give more space in here. And lastly, last but not least, all the design, I want to check your greeting, like how to use your grid. So
are you using your grid? Like, are you sticking things to a grid, or you basically you're just like eyeing it and mixing a line by yourself? So what I would like to do is just, I'm gonna create a grid and test if your content is sticking to a grid or not. If not, then I will strongly suggest you that like you should find a grid, and you should really use a grid, because using grid, as I mentioned in my grading video, like even if you feel like your design skill is not so good, or if you're just learning, with a grid, it can definitely help a bunch. So in here, okay, so this, I can see that you're sort of lying things, but what I will do with this bun is just like stick to the grid. It doesn't need the padding to be this big. So this is good. But again, like this little thing, right? This is not really 100% aligned. So it's just very little details, you know, like this is like pretty good aligned, but just a little detail. But I can see that you're using grid. It just some of the area is not really sticking to it, so that makes it a bit awkward. But in general, that's good. See, like this is aligned to the grid, so that's good. Great job there. Down below here, what I probably will do is I will move this to stick to the grid as well. Like, why is some of the section here sticking to the left side and this section does not, right? So this, I will just make it stick to the grid as well. And the footer too, like just make it stick to the grid. But overall, I would say it's not bad. Good job on that. But yeah, just a little thing. Try to improve on that and you'll get better.
So that's it for the video. Thank you for watching. And I hope that like my feedback is gonna be helpful for you. And I hope that it will not just for you, I hope that other people can learn something from it as well. And if you like this kind of style, if you like the way that I review works, feel free to send me yours as well. I'm happy to review that. I think I'm gonna make this kind of video once a week, so that like you can, I mean, every week I'm just gonna pick one to review. So if you like it, send me your work. And if you like this channel, if you like the stuff I talk about, subscribe to my channel as well, and give this video a thumbs up. And I will see you guys next time. Cheers.